see this location. It's perfect. It looks like hell.
all day? Because I'd like to know how to conduct myself.
Traitor.
What?
You didn't go to the studio behind my back?
No.
Don't you do it. Don't you fucking lie to me.
Yes, I went to them, Derek. Yes, I did.
I rest my case.
You know why?
I rest my fucking case!
You know why, Derek? Because if I had told you about Billy, there would have been no meeting. You'd have picked up the phone, reamed somebody out, or you would have pulled your... I'm walking out of the room and I hope you feel like shit.
What?
Oh, please, you did it today. Perfect example. You don't like how things are going. You excuse yourself from the proceedings. That's why they talk to me, Derek, because I'm the only one left in the room.
I'm sorry. Is this a professional argument or a personal one?
Is there any difference with you?
Your cell phone is ringing.
This is the infirmary. The prison had its own doctor. They did surgeries here and everything. Didn't know if you'd want to use it or not.
Sure.
Actually, you know what? That reminds me of something.
Jeez.
I'm supposed to ask if we could get a copy of your script.
Why?
Well, the film commission, it's appointed by the governor, and it's really just a formality I have to ask.
The fuck was that?
It's an old building. Maybe it's haunted. I'm sure it can get fixed if it's a problem.
If it's a problem. Jesus.
Derek Plato. Yeah. I'm sorry, what? I can't hear you. Can you hear me? Is that better? Yeah, a little. Listen, you hear from Olivia? I don't have anything to say to him. Jesus Christ, all right. Fine, whatever, put him through. This is Derek. Listen, you're gonna have to speak up, I've got a bad connection. You're gonna have to speak up, I got a bad connection here. I don't have a problem with Billy as an actor. I never said that. He's perfect. He's just not a writer. But he wants to be. He does if he wants to. That's not what you said. No. You said. I'm sorry. Did you just call me pissy? Well, how would you like it? You wouldn't like it either, would you? Would you, you cheap bastard?
What the fuck is the matter with you?
What, are you in high school? Didn't your mama tell you not to play with other people's shit?
No. We're not ducking out on this. You look me in the eye and tell me that I'm a traitor. Look at me.
chamber is down at the end of the hall here. You know, something I always found kind of funny. If you look at these cells, you'll see they're numbered. And the lower the number, the closer you are to the chair. It's like 3, 2, 1. Lift off. They did the executions right here. They took out the chair when they shut it down. It was in a museum for a while. Nothing like the movies, is it? Over here are the controls. Now, as far as I know, the internal wiring is still intact, but the power to the facility's been shut down for years, so you need to get an electrician before we get cranked up for production. Do you need a chair?
Room 15 by 15 feet. Gonna present some lighting problems.
Listen.
And now Bob is talking again. Don't you have something you'd rather be doing?
I'm sorry?
You don't want to be here because I am a prick. I don't want you here because you're annoying the shit out of me. So, spare me the sales pitch. Get the fuck out of my way and go wait in the car. Better still, go home. I'll let myself out.
Scare me, Bob? Thank you.
a prison film.
Does that mean there has to be a rape scene in it?
No, that's the point. That's
Look,
the whole
I'm
point
not saying
of
it,
the...
I'm not saying it doesn't happen. I mean, obviously it does happen, okay? I'm just saying, haven't we seen that before? I mean, it's been done to death.
That's what I'm saying. That's Derek's point. That's the point of the whole film, is to blow up the cliche and really examine this thing,
Look,
right?
Olivia, you don't have to sell me. I'm sold. I'm just trying to get you to understand it from Billy's point of view.
Which is what exactly?
He thinks if you show a brutal prison rape in the first minute of a film that you're going to lose your audience, and you're not going to get them back no matter how brilliant your film is.
That's bullshit. You know it. He's not concerned about the audience. He's concerned about his career.
I'm just telling you what he told me. I mean, it's not like he wants to rewrite the script or anything.
But he does. That's exactly what he wants.
It's just the opening, Derek.
The opening is the whole movie. It's the whole movie! Don't just sit there and tell me it's just the opening. Did you even read the script?
Derek, sit down, please.
The opening stays, period. End of conversation.
Joke.
you'd let me go. You're a bigger man than me, all right? You're more important than I am. You've got all the power. Let me go. I'll get you some water. Can I please have some water?
Somebody else, right?
Look, Derek, the studio is really excited about you and Billy working together on this one. Right?
Definitely.
This is a deal breaker. Is that what you're telling me? Because I trusted you, and now I'm the problem. Jesus. Talk about getting fucked up the ass. The freaking irony.
Executive, my ass.
Derek, don't.
I've got a plane to catch, do you?
See if you sit over there.
Fuck you.
I mean, suit yourself. I mean, you could do it any way you want, but far be it for me to give you direction.
You just won't be seen.
Who are you?
I ask the questions. You answer the questions.
What?
I ask the questions. You answer the questions.
Fuck you, you sick fuck.
You have a surprisingly limited vocabulary for such a celebrated artiste. But that's your, what's the word? That's your idiom, isn't it? Huh? Grit, brutality, unflinching honesty. Almost unwatchable. Now, isn't that what the LA Times said? Derek Plato's directorial debut is almost unwatchable in the best possible way. I thought that was pretty clever.
It was the New York Times.
The New York Times. Of course it was the New York Times. How silly of me. This is really static.
probably okay. It's very serioso, like your films.
Tell me about your early work. Or is that too heavy to start with? What's your favorite prison film? Shooting for some irony.
Let's talk about your third feature.
Confessions. Big breakthrough. Critical acclaim. Winner at Cannes, etc., etc. Generate a lot of controversy, which you seem to relish, particularly the Pope's condemnation. I think you said, shock is good for the system. What did you mean by that? And in your career project, your first major studio film. The story centers on a relationship between two convicts that begins with a brutal rape and culminates in a 30-year love affair. What do you hope to achieve? Come on, Barry. Let's not drag this thing on any longer than necessary, okay?
If I answer your questions, will you let me go?
That was the question, Derek.
All right, damn it. Here's your first one.
Hey, I don't make the rules, Derek.
Who does?
I ask the questions. You answer the questions.
Can I at least get some water? I need something to eat or drink, for Christ's sakes.
I can't answer your fucking questions if I'm dead. Features.
And
now I'm doing my fourth.
What? sufficient reason to make a movie?
What is that?
Careful. Tell me about your early work.
What do you mean? You mean film school or?
Ask the questions, you answer the questions.
How am I supposed to? Okay, film school. My thesis film was decent enough to get some financing, so I expanded it and made it the first feature.
Wisteria, your take on the Columbine Massacre, in which you told the story through the killer's perspective.
Through the kid's perspective.
The killer's perspective.
The shooter's, yeah, whatever.
Did you think that was appropriate?
I don't know what you mean.
Did you think that it was appropriate to sympathize with a pair of mass murderers?
I wasn't sympathizing with them, I was making a movie.
Oh. It was about you, not them. Well, what else?
That's it.
Your early work, Derek.
I messed around some in high school.
Messed around?
Yeah, little shorts, practical jokes, nothing anybody ever saw.
That's not entirely true, though, is it?
There's a class project.
Yeah. Let's hear about that.
We were supposed to profile somebody that we admired.
Well, you don't get to sit behind a desk like this by accident. You gotta earn it. You gotta work hard for it, and you better start establishing those good work habits early. Early. You gotta dash. Dedication, attitude, sacrifice, hard work.
So you admired your principal?
No.
So you chose him for your subject because...
Because he was a prick.
He was married, 3 kids, always popping off of that. Good moral values, good Christian values, whatever. He was banging the homecoming queen her whole junior year.
You understand something. You turned in this project?
Fuck yeah, I did.
Did you get a good grade?
I got expelled. It was worth it.
Now why do you say that?
Because I got the fucker fired.
Last I heard, he was a manager at some taco place. Probably still mouthing the same crap.
Dash this, you sorry sack of shit.
And his family? What happened to them?
Is that what this is about? Fuck. No questions.
Did your early success exposing the hypocrisy of authority figures inform your later work? Because I'm sensing a parallel here with Confessions, in which you depicted a graphic sex act between a defrocked priest and a mother superior that took place on an altar of the Catholic Church. Derek. You're not cooperating, Derek.
I don't understand the question.
Do you enjoy making movies?
What difference does it make?
Careful.
It's what I do.
Why?
Because.
Elaborate.
Because it's what I'm good at.
Why?
Because I've been doing it forever.
Why?
For Christ's sakes, because, all right? You want my philosophy or whatever, my mission statement? Then that's it. Because. I'm not trying to change the world or make it a better place or anything like that. I'm just... None of that bullshit.
What are you trying to do?
I show people the world. way it is. Not the way it could be, or the way it should be, just the way it is.
Which is?
Which is a place that creates psychos like you, who lock people up and ask them pointless questions.
You know, that was beautiful. Could you do that again and use the room a little bit more? You know, just get up and just move around or something.
What? Fuck. What the?
No? Yeah, you're right. We'd lose all the spontaneity. Okay. Yeah. All right, where were we? I think this is funny. I mean, not funny as in, like, ha-ha. Funny, but... Almost everyone would agree that your films lack a solution. What do you think that's about? What do you think that is, Eric? Do you fear closure?
Final word?
Judgment. Is that what you're afraid of, Derek?
Come on, you piece of shit! Come on! Derek, honey,
food instead of throwing it.
I did. What I could reach.
How was it?
It made me sleepy.
Is that such a bad thing?
No. I guess not. I need to eat.
And?
And I will. Cooperate.
Observer changes things. Have you seen that photograph of the naked Vietnamese girl running away from Saigon?
Yeah.
I mean, her face is screaming in agony. I mean, her skin is burned. I mean, she had to strip off all her clothes because they were on fire. Her face is contorted. She's weeping. Her toes were pointed out. And her hands are bent at the wrist. I mean, I believe it won the photographer a Pulitzer Prize.
Yeah.
Now, immediately after he took the picture, the photographer went to her aid. And he kept in contact with her for years after that. Made sure she was okay and lived on. She survived. Was reasonably happy. Sent her money and so forth. But he was racked with guilt. All the accolades brought him no peace. Because even though he did help her, his first instinct was to take the picture. Because if he would have helped her first, you never would have gotten the shot. Right, Derek? Ah!
best you could come up with?
That was very neighborly of you, Derek.
Rule number three.
Play nice.
Thank you.
be an alarmist here, but you're running a little short on time, in case you haven't noticed.
Film it, then. Stop the bullshit and do it. You don't want to know about my early work. You don't want to know anything, because you already know. You know everything about me. See me suffer. Fuck you. I'm not gonna give you the satisfaction. I quit. Game over.
You wanna switch sides?
Thank you.
deep. It's as if they never happened.
Moments aren't perfect. I'm certainly not perfect. You know, people make mistakes.
Sometimes you remember it in a different way.
I'm sorry.
Here, Derek? Like a full body or three quarter? You don't want to get too tight. Or do we, Derek? How's this? Yeah. We like. there.
Now we finally remember.
We got the shot.
You make the rules, Derek.
I just enforce them.
Okay.